Hi, and welcome to Scope Month. My name is Daniel Bogdanoff, and today is Wednesday, March 22nd, and we are going to give away six 1000 X Series scopes today because someone completed the Find Daniel contest. They posted this picture to the company's WeChat channel over in China because the cutout was in Shanghai this week. For today's scope tip, we're going to look at use your cowl on your oscilloscope. So sometimes you need a dongle like we used to make that waveform for the St. Patrick's Day video. This scope actually routes all the signals internally, so you don't have to have any uncertainty related to your BNCs. The behavior of electrical components can change with temperature, so the impedance actually changes, and if the impedance changes in your acquisition system, the scope might think it's seen a signal that's slightly different from what is actually present. So you can run a user cowl at a specific temperature to verify that your scope is going to work the way you expect it to at those operating temperatures, especially if you're working outside of the normal room temperature range. Now, there are a couple caveats for user cowls. First, if you do a user cowl, you're going to wipe out all calibration already on the scope. And second, you're not going to get a traceable calibration. So if you take your equipment into an accredited professional cowl lab, the equipment that they use is going to be traceable all the way back to their base SI unit standards. But if you do an internal cowl, you're kind of at the mercy of your components. Now, fortunately, we use top-of-the-line components for our scope, so if you do run a user cowl, you'll probably get a pretty good measurement, but it won't be a substitute for a full professional calibration. Let's go ahead and run a cowl on the scope. I'm going to go into utility, and first I have to disable the cowl protection. So if you want to protect your cowl, you can check that cowl protection box, and no one else is going to come and wipe away your calibrations. So you can uncheck that, and then I'm going to go back to utility, service, and I'm going to hit start user cowl. I have nothing connected because my signals are all routed internally. This will take approximately 7 minutes. It's going to run through a whole series of algorithms to check the calibration of the scope. And while that's running, let's go ahead and draw our winners for the day. So I'm going to draw six winners, and these six 1000 X Series scopes are also going to come with a warranty because it's Warranty Wednesday. So six winners, and I'm going to draw those names. And our winners for today, Warren Watts, Nathan Hensel, Dan Van Deventer, Alexander Kandalinstev, Robert Thal, and Luke Johnson. Congratulations to our winners. We'll be in touch with you shortly. And let's tune back in after this cowl has run its course. The user cowl has passed. So what that means is that the scope has internally optimized the signal path through the acquisition system. That's all for today. Johnny has a new blog over on the Keysight Oscilloscopes blog. Check out the link in the description. We have a new post every week with some helpful oscilloscope tips and tricks. If you prefer video tips and tricks, check out some of the other videos on our Keysight Oscilloscopes YouTube channel and hit the subscribe button so you can see when new videos come out. Also, check us out on Facebook and on Instagram. You can ask me questions and follow me on Twitter at Keysight_Daniel. That's all we have for today. Thanks for watching. I will see you tomorrow.
You two are impossible to work with.